What is the definition of Holocaust denier? Is it basically if the six-pointed star, six with Sorry. Six zeros of the six-pointed star people were killed? Yeah?
Sorry, what?
A six with six zeros is the death toll of people.
Yeah, but what's that got to do with the star?
I just think we're seeing the number six very, a lot, you know?
The death toll in Gaza since October the 7th, 2023 is currently impossible to calculate, with conservative estimates putting the figure close to 200,000 Palestinian men, women and children slaughtered by the Jews for the crime of being born in the wrong place in under a year. The Jewish Holocaust, by comparison, is one of the worst recorded events in world history, with the number of calculated Jewish Holocaust survivors increasing year on year. As anti-Semitism continues to increase, it's important to spread awareness of some of the most tragic and definitely real Holocaust survivor stories. Today we're not going to be focusing on whether 6 million Jews died in the Holocaust. The number 6 million was circulating for years in headlines before the war had even started, and the census numbers for religious populations around the world actually show an increase in the Jewish population from 1933 to 1948, but that's not the point. The point is the suffering that these people went through. Bernard Holstein described his ordeal at the hands of Nazi masturbation machines, hobbling back to camp with painfully swollen scrotums. Mosh Peer survived being gassed not once, not twice, but six separate times, quoted in the Montreal Gazette saying, "Maybe children resist better, I don't know." But that's nothing compared to this elderly Jewish couple, one of whom survived 11 death camps, with the other surviving the atomic bomb dropped on Nagasaki. But that's still not the record, with this survivor making it through a dozen death camps. One 12-year-old was on her way back to the gas chamber to be killed when she collapsed from hunger and was hospitalized back to full health before being smuggled out to Vienna, an incredibly close call. Yitzhak Gannon was about to be put in a gas chamber built for 200 people, but he was number 201. They wanted to kill him but were forced to let him live because of sheer luck. Maurice Hubert describes the ordeals at the Buchenwald camp, where one Jew a day was thrown into a cage with a bear and an eagle. The bear would tear him apart and the eagle would pick at his bones. Unbelievable, but it happened. Helena Burenbaum was one of nearly 200 Jewish women thrown into a gas chamber, but fortunately the Nazis ran out of gas and they were released the next morning. One survivor told of a Jew roller coaster that would take a rail car high speed down a corridor, flinging 15 Jews at a time into an automatically opening oven. But that still didn't compare to the Belzec camp, where Jews were forced to stand naked on a metal plate that would submerge them up to their necks in water and electrocute them until they were nothing but ash. Babies were thrown into the air like frisbees and shot at, not to mention the soap, the wallets, the lampshades, and the soccer balls, all made from Jewish flesh. The Nazis were so brutally sadistic that they devised a giant electric chair so huge it could electrocute 10,000 Jewish victims a day. They even drowned a man to death in a large pot of soup and proceeded to eat it and serve it just like normal soup.
Och sen åt soppan som vanligt. Och såna grejer hände ju då.
Another time, I don't know why, but we also had dwarves. One of them, Mr. Levy, was a quadriplegic. His arms and legs didn't function properly. And they brought this Roma woman. She was forced to lay down on the floor. They put the dwarf on top of her and forced them to have sex. They made us all watch. We were not allowed to move our heads. If we looked away, they'd shoot us. Mr. Levy died the next day.
Never forgive, never forget.